Good evening, everyone. Our big story at 6, pushback on gun control in Cecil County as council members there unanimously pass a resolution opposing the recently passed Maryland Firearms Safety Act of 2013.
That bill was drawn up by Council Vice President Alan McCarthy, who says he was under a lot of pressure from residents. 11 News reporter Lowell Mulser has the latest from Elkton.
Cecil County is now the first county in Maryland to challenge the State Firearms Safety Act as a resolution was passed here in County Council not too long ago. The hope is that other counties around the state will join their efforts, even though at this point it's strictly symbolic.
The amount of support that I've received for this resolution has been overwhelming.
For Alan McCarthy, Vice President of the Cecil County Council, it was something he felt he needed to do. After being approached by a large amount of residents with concern over the recently passed Maryland Firearms Safety Act, McCarthy helped draft a resolution deeming it unconstitutional. It passed council by a 4-0 vote.
We feel the Second Amendment is granted to us by the United States Constitution and the Bill of Rights that was passed in 1791. We feel that this is a usurpation of the government's power to do these types of things, and we think that we have no obligation lawfully to abide by what they're making us or asking us to do.
The Firearms Safety Act is one of the strictest set of rules in the country concerning gun control. For example, under the law, gun owners now have to license their firearms and have to get fingerprinted. Almost 50 different firearms have been banned, and handgun magazines are now limited to no more than 10 rounds. McCarthy says he actually supports certain rules in the bill, but feels more time should be spent on mental health.
I basically do not think that people who are convicted felons should have guns. I don't think that people should have automatic weapons. Basically, we are not making any outright demands or making any threats. We're just saying that we don't think that this is right.
As far as what can happen now is really up to other counties around the state. So far, Carroll County has written to McCarthy in support, even if it is only symbolic.
It doesn't really have any big teeth. I mean, I don't know that we can do to oppose the state. But the thing is, if enough people sign up behind it, that in itself is a powerful force.
And while resolutions like this one here in Cecil County are passed, there are also petition efforts going on to try and get that state firearms safety law on the November ballot. In Elkton, I'm Lowell Mulser, WBAL-TV 11 News.